Okay, so as I said, that oxidation can be even brought about by some chemical substances. This is another way in which oxidation takes place. So there are certain chemical substances which make oxygen available for oxidation to be brought about. I repeat, there are certain chemical substances which make oxygen available for oxidation to be brought about. So this particular example is based on that. So let us see what that example is and how does oxidation take place over here. So here we have a compound CH3CH2OH. In between we have small dash, but they are not dashes, they are referred to as bonds. Since there is only one single line, it's a single bond. This is also called as a linear structure or a linear formula, because linear means straight one line, and the formula has been written in one straight line in, and it even shows the bonds that are present. So it's a linear formula of ethyl alcohol. We have just now seen the formula of ethyl alcohol, but we had written it in a different way. We had written it as C2H5OH. The meaning is the same. Here also we have C2, two atoms of carbon you can see. H5 we had written. Here also you can see 5 CH3 and CH2 is written, but total hydrogen is 5 here and OH. So it was C2H5OH. Here it is just written in a different way, CH3CH2OH. So here you can have more information about even bonds. So that is ethyl alcohol. And on the arrow we have written certain things. Here you have can see oxygen. It's written in a bracket, which indicates that it's nascent oxygen, that is newly born or fresh oxygen. It is always written in a bracket. And here we have written K2Cr2O7, that is potassium dichromate. Okay, so this is potassium dichromate, that is K2Cr2O7, and this is sulfuric acid. So what have we done is we have taken potassium dichromate, and to that we have added few drops of sulfuric acid. So now this becomes acidified potassium dichromate. Are you following? Potassium dichromate, to that we have added few drops of sulfuric acid, and that makes it acidified potassium dichromate. Now this gives us a product CH3COOH, and the name of the product is acetic acid. Again, I would ask you not to go in for balancing. This is only one example. Here you can see few dots, and so it is only given as an example. So here what is happening? Here we are finding that oxygen is getting added to the reactant, and you can see the new product, that is with two oxygen atoms here. There's only one oxygen over here, so it becomes CH3COOH. So where is this oxygen coming from? So it is coming from this potassium dichromate on getting acidified. So if you are using acidified potassium dichromate, then potassium dichromate acts as a oxidizing agent, and it makes oxygen available for oxidation to be brought about of the reactant. So such substances are called as oxidizing agents or oxidants. Now let us see what is written here and if we can understand still better. Oxygen is made available to reactant. What is the reactant? Ethyl alcohol. For oxidation by acidified potassium dichromate. So this is acidified potassium dichromate, which we have written here also. Such substances that make oxygen available for oxidation reaction are called oxidants or oxidizing agents. So we have many such oxidizing agents. We have potassium permanganate, that is KMnO4. We have hydrogen peroxide, that is H2O2, and even ozone, that is O3, also as an oxidizing agent. So all these substances make oxygen available for oxidation. So just like potassium dichromate, potassium permanganate, that is KMnO4, is also to be used in acidified form. So here this is acidified form, and that makes oxygen available for oxidation. So with this we come to the end of oxidation reaction. If you wish, you can refer to page number 42 of your textbook, in which you have a pink colored box, and that box says do you know, and there are reactions which are given over there. This box has been cancelled from your syllabus this year, but you can always go through it, and it tells you about the various types of oxidizing agents or oxidants. So now in the next slide we will be studying about the reduction reaction. We now move on to the next type of reaction, that is reduction reaction. Now I have taken again two examples. These examples are not a part of your textbook. The textbook doesn't give any example of reduction reaction. But we need to understand what is reduction also. So for that I have taken two examples. Let us discuss them. Here the first one is carbon and reacting with hydrogen gas. So when hydrogen gas is passed over carbon, we get methane, that is CH4, which is also a gas. Now in this reaction, hydrogen has been added to the reactant, that is carbon. Now this is addition of hydrogen and we get the product methane. So reduction is addition of hydrogen. Second example, if we see ozone, O3, that is ozone, in presence of light and heat, it gives us molecular oxygen gas along with one atom of oxygen. It is written inside the bracket, box bracket, and this is called as nascent oxygen. Nascent means newly born or fresh. So here we find that oxygen is getting removed. Earlier it was O3, but now it has become O2. One oxygen atom has been removed. So this is removal of oxygen from the reactant. So with this we come to the definition, that is either addition of hydrogen or removal of oxygen from the reactant will be referred to as reduction reaction. So chemical reactions in which reactants gain hydrogen or lose oxygen to form the product are called reduction reactions. So it is just the reverse of oxidation. In oxidation it was addition of oxygen and removal of hydrogen, but in reduction it is addition or gain of hydrogen and loss of oxygen. So this is examples of reduction reaction. Let us go to the next slide. Here we have one more example of oxidation reaction. You can just revise the example of ethyl alcohol getting converted to acetic acid as an oxidation reaction example that we have done. The reaction is given in your textbook also. And this oxidation of ethyl alcohol to acetic acid was brought about in presence of acidified potassium dichromate, which was acting as an oxidizing agent or oxidant. We are studying one more example of oxidation reaction. But here we have potassium permanganate, that is acidified using sulfuric acid as our oxidant or oxidizing agent. And the substance that is getting oxidized is ferrous sulfate. Let us see the reaction. We have potassium permanganate, potassium 1 plus, and permanganate ion MnO4 minus 1. So we get KMnO4. Ferrous sulfate and sulfuric acid, you are going to get all sulfates, potassium sulfate, manganese sulfate, ferric sulfate and water. So we have potassium, manganese and iron, three metals on reactant side, and they all have given their respective sulfates. What are we concerned with is only ferrous sulfate getting converted to ferric sulfate, that is getting oxidized. Ferrous sulfate getting oxidized to ferric sulfate in presence of acidified potassium permanganate. So from reactant side we have taken ferrous sulfate, from product side we have taken ferric sulfate. Now what have we to do is to write down the ionic reaction. Both these are ionic reaction, representing ionic reaction. So if I have to write down the ionic reaction for FeSO4, it will be Fe2+. How has FeSO4 been formed? Fe2+ plus sulfate 2-. And on this side, this is Fe3+, because now here you can see 3. So it is Fe3+ and sulfate radical SO4 2-. We have 3 sulfate, so 3 here, 2 iron, that is ferric ions, so 2 we have written here. Now again, net ionic reaction, if we have to write down, again we are going to be concerned only with this iron over here, that is Fe2+. So net ionic reaction Fe2+ here, and it is getting converted to Fe3+. Now iron lost 2 electrons, valency of iron here we can see that it is 2, but now it has changed to 3. So how is this possible? Only when this ferrous ion loses one more electron, so it gains one more positive charge over it and gets converted to the ferric ion. So we get a new definition of oxidation reaction from here, that is loss of electrons is oxidation, and I have used the abbreviation LEO. Loss of electrons is called oxidation. LEO is one sun sign, and you can remember this abbreviation. So loss of electrons is called oxidation. So here ferrous ion loses one electron to develop one more positive charge over it, and hence it gets converted into ferric ion, that is Fe3+. So we have learned one more concept of oxidation, that is loss of electrons is called oxidation. Earlier we have studied addition of oxygen or loss of hydrogen as oxidation. One more concept of oxidation is loss of electrons is called oxidation. So here FeSO4 is oxidized by acidified KMnO4. Thus KMnO4 is oxidant or oxidizing agent. So the oxidation of FeSO4 is being brought about by acidified potassium permanganate. The net ionic reaction represents the oxidation brought about by KMnO4. So I hope you have understood this, a new concept regarding oxidation, that is loss of electrons. If you have any doubt, we will clear it in the live sessions that we organize. Let's go on to the next topic.